Here's the pathway between my house and my neighbor's house. The spaces between the flagstones have been sealed with a jointing mortar to replace the earth that was there previously. The material is very strong. After about a week, you can apply pressure washing or power washing to it. It's also very permeable to water. In this video, I'll show two ways in which this jointing mortar can be applied. Now let's go back to the beginning. So this is the pathway, the original, and it goes about 27 feet long. Here's another part of the pathway in the backyard that's going to have to be dealt with. In this case, a jointing mortar of a different color will be used. The jointing mortar I'm using is from a company called Romex, and their product, Rompox Easy, is the one to obtain for this project. It's manufactured in Germany by a German company. This bucket weighs 33 pounds. The question is, how much is it and where can I get it? I paid $90 Canadian per bucket in June of 2021. It can be obtained at various locations across Canada, which I'll show you on their website.
Type in RomexCanada.com. Then a page comes up in a little introduction. If you go to find a store and scroll down, you can see it's in Western Canada, Eastern Canada, and in my case, I'm in the area of Hamilton Builder Supply, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 areas to choose from. And under media, you have some videos that could be helpful.
The manufacturer says that the spaces here must be at least a quarter of an inch, so I've got no problem here in the pathway. But he says you should dig down here at least 1 inch all the way through. And so, for example, you could use a block like this that's an inch high and then put it here and then use it to gauge the depth each way. He also suggested you could dig down to the height of the flagstone, but that could be quite deep. So that just needs, you could do it, but it needs a lot more material. So maybe an inch to an inch and a half would be fine. Also, we'll be digging a trench here along the, following the path of the flagstones, an inch deep or so, an inch to 2 inches deep, all the way along on both sides. So I'll come back when this is all done. Here are the trenches that have been dug out now. So using the 1 inch block here, okay, you can see I'm more than an inch. In other cases, I'm maybe right at an inch.
Opening for the first time. Cut with scissors. The mortar is vacuum packed, which means once exposed to air, the material is activated and the hardening process begins. Don't worry, there's an ample time to spread it out.
First, almost forgot, I gotta wet this down.
I poured it out like this, as I saw on other videos. The whole bucket should be used up in one application, so have enough grooves made to use it all up.
Squeegee it into all the spaces.
A pro tip, if you don't use it all up, fold the plastic over the remaining material with maybe a brick on top, then add water to the bucket until the water is over the brick. This ensures that air will not get into the mortar and it can be used at a later time. A squeegee method at first, I switched to using a trowel because the wide spaces made this method more useful. If the spaces are narrow, the squeegee method is probably better. But in this case, I could control the amounts and placements more accurately. It's important not to tamp down the mortar, as this will reduce the permeability to water. A gentle motion of the trowel is good for giving a smooth surface. I didn't spray water over the area and found that the mortar hardened just fine. Here's the original again from the back. And here is the final result. A closer look shows a difference in colors from different buckets. This was a rare event in Romex's experience, but it turned out to be an interesting learning experience. I scraped off a few millimeters from the top and made my own mixture using the deco resin and white sand. You could use any fine sand of your choice. And the result was a uniform color, which I preferred here. I first scraped off the surface to a depth which varied from about a quarter of an inch to half an inch. I then added resin to the sand in a ratio of 1 liter of resin to 55 pounds of sand. In this case, I used 20 pounds sand, and so I used a corresponding volume of resin. The sand was white quartz. After first mixing in the left bucket, it is a good idea to dump it all into a second one to ensure good mixing. I then hand troweled the mixture as before. The color changed to a bluish color. But after it all solidified, I noticed a problem with sweeping. As I swept the area to clear debris, mainly leaves from the neighbors, I noticed that small amounts of the mortar were coming off. It wasn't long before the surface underneath was showing up in some spots. Now, if all the mortar is the same color to begin with, this may not be much of a problem, although the level of the surface will gradually lower over time, and this would not be good. So, to prevent this from happening, especially in my case, where the new surface was fairly thin, I applied a coat of polyurethane. Here's a can of polyurethane with the foam brush I used to dab the liquid onto the surface. The color changed again to a gray color, but hard to see here, but it was all uniform and quite nice. Now, polyurethane is applied most often to outside wood surfaces to protect them against rain and snow. The question arises, will it reduce the permeability of the mortar and stop water from percolating downward? This would not be a good thing. So here's a test with a cup of water. The water did go down, although maybe not quite as fast. I guess one coat of the polyurethane applied by dabbing with a foam brush doesn't seal everywhere perfectly. So this solution stopped the removal of mortar when sweeping and still allowed water to pass through. This ends my adventure with adding Romex's jointing mortar to flagstones.